Music was always in my life. And my sister and I, we learned to harmonize with each other. My dad, my sister and I, we would do like three-part harmony. And, you know, my mom, she loves playing percussion. So she brings in the percussion and the rhythmic aspect. And I think we could have made a band, but it didn't happen. I was born in Scarborough, Ontario, Canada, at Scarborough General Hospital. My dad, he's from Japan. He was the one who introduced me to music, actually. When I was 4, I was sang a song called My Dog Washington. My dad was on the piano, my sister was my partner in crime, and that was my first show. But the one thing that I was so mad about was how my mom did my hair. I was so mad because she put my hair in a ponytail like right here, and I looked like a little samurai, and I was like, no, I don't want my hair to be like this. So my experience was great, but I just did not like how my hair was. The sequence of how I learned music to get to where I am now was, it started off with piano. When I got into my teens, I started getting more interested in singing. You know, singing was more natural to me, singing was more fun. I could sing anywhere, I didn't have to have a piano with me. My mom is from Brazil. She is from Bahia. She has been a big influence of Brazilian music, and I enjoy really singing in Portuguese. I love most Brazilian styles.
I always feel unstoppable. I always felt I could always get myself out of any shit because I have so much power, and I don't need to sleep, I don't need holidays. And after this panic attack, it turned out my heart attack was a panic attack actually. I felt so weak and I felt so vulnerable and I felt a little helpless. And that moment when I heard this voice, I had a reason again to become strong, because my voice told me, get this energy, get this voice heard by the world. I went home very inspired. I had this word Kana in my head and João de Deus. I had never heard of him before.
John of God is a internationally known and recognized medium who works with spirits and entities, angels. And his mission on earth is to heal people.
My wife approached me and said, this Brazilian healer, João de Deus, comes to Austria. He will perform at the Salzburg Arena, he will do some healings there, and I want to go, do you want to join me? Normally I would say, no, have fun, I have my job to do, and it was just, the bell rang, oh my God, John of God, this is the word, João de Deus, I heard 2 days ago, maybe Kana will sing, so I googled it up, the website, and I saw performance of Kana. A big hall, 5,000 people waiting for John of God, and one girl singing on stage, just to a track, no band, 1 hour. Everyone was listening, it was super quiet. 25% of all people surrounding me started crying, and so did I, and my wife next to me said, you have to produce her. I feel it now, I experienced this. And she said, we have to do this. Yeah. So at that moment, we both committed to it.
I met him there, or actually he met me, but I don't remember seeing him clearly. And then he came to LA in March of 2013, February, March. And he offered me a record deal.
that was maybe one of the most interesting and weirdest experiences in my career. Normally artists, they give an arm for a record contract or for whatever. And Carla was so cool and so reserved. She was very friendly, she met me.
Yeah, I was kind of hesitant, actually. I was like, I thought it was great that someone wanted to offer me a record deal. It was a super opportunity, but it got me really nervous.
And she said, I think your idea and what you want is great, and I totally support it. I just know if I'm your artist. And I was like, what? I just wanted to do it with her because it was her energy that took my heart, and I couldn't do this with someone else. So I was honest to her. I said, I do it with you or this project won't exist. And she was like, okay.
Give me some time so I can think about it and then I'll let you know.
And then I thought my honesty was impressive enough that she would call after a week and say, okay, let's do it. She let me wait 27 days.
Later, he told me, I thought that was like a business strategy that you had. And I'm like, no, I really didn't know. You know, I really didn't know how I felt. It was something super new for me. I had no idea what the commitment meant, you know? So it took me some time, but I ended up accepting, so.
Making Jokes, the Never Ending album. In fact, we did the recordings 2 years ago and we will release the album now.
It was a really long process. We basically had an album done, but after that was done, a lot of things started to come up. You know, throughout this process, he started to get to know me better, I started to get to know him better.
Now we have an album that you can really stand behind it, and I'm super happy.
It's okay.
Hard to expect something, you know, because it's like a game. It's that you just have no idea what's gonna happen, you know. You just go along with it, and if it's a success, great. If not, keep doing what you love. Washington, we go out together every day and jump and chase and run.